Good afternoon, girls.
Right,
Missy just came back from a trip. She went down to go see her sister who lives in London, and then they decided to go off to Barcelona for a couple of days. You know, check out museums, do a bit of shopping, sightseeing, all that good stuff. So when she decided to go, she said, well, what do you want me to bring you back? So, you know, some people might want a mug or a little t-shirt or something like that. I said, no, I'll have some cured pork products, please. So this is what she brought me back. Oh, yes. This is very similar. I'll say similar, see if it's slightly different to prosciutto, you know, Parma ham. Same sort of way that they make it. Get the meat, cover it in salt for about a month, 6 weeks, and then air dry it. This particular cut has been air dried for 18 months in a cave for all places. There's different quality levels. So this particular style piece here, which has been deboned, you'll have exactly the same shape piece of meat, but you'll have different prices, basically because not all porkies are the same, the meat doesn't cure the same, so you're gonna have a different sort of level of quality. This is about midway on the quality scale for this particular cut. There are other cuts, like with the sort of absolutely full leg with the bone in, you know, and a little trotter on the end. They got to about £8 to £9. This is a £5 slab. It's made by, Estripe Negra. And for all of you who think Estripe must mean pig in Spanish, you're wrong. You can go check that out yourself if you want. But the Negra, black, that's basically the pig that they have. It's a sort of, it's from Iberia, and it's like one of the sort of animals that's sort of very, very local to this area. What happens with these is, say they run around in the woods, etc., and for about 3 months before they're actually killed, they gorge themselves on acorns, and that imparts a very subtle, delicate flavour to the meat. This is a a 2.2 kilogram piece, so £5 in weight. So how much do you think £5 of ham would cost you? Wrong. This particular one cost €80, which works out at about $120, something like that. Yeah, it's fucking expensive. It's not the most expensive one though. This is a £5, all right? I've seen one, but there's a top quality one, which was, I think, £8.5 with a bone still in it. Top quality one, and that was €275. No, she didn't buy me that one. Fucking tight bitch. Right, the great thing about this sort of, these things is that the way that they're cured is, with the salt here, what you're gonna have is when you cut this piece up, there's not huge amounts of fat in these particular sections. There is a little bit on the back, and fat is your friend, gives you flavor. This section is gonna be quite salty, which is quite nice for this style of meat. But as you come further up, the meat on the inside hasn't been had so much salt into it. So it becomes sweeter as you move up the piece of meat. And obviously more delicious as you go. Excuse me. So what I'm gonna have to do is to chop off some very, very thin slices and distribute them to a few of my friends. A mate of mine got a full leg ham about 2 years ago. Every time we went around his house, you know, he sort of for a couple of beers, he'd sort of whip out the old ham and slice us off some bits. And it's very nice with a couple of cold ones, trust me. So yeah, that's the sort of thing I like to get as a present. You can stick a t-shirt up your ass. And this is also one of the reasons why I could never follow Judaism or the Muslim faith. Sorry, any fucking religion that doesn't allow you to eat pork, bah, no way, Jose. Can you imagine life without a bacon sandwich? Now that would be hell. So there you go. Mr. Porky's given his life. This will last me now 2 months, something like that. Once it's opened, keep it in a cool, dry place, and it's absolutely fine. There's no need to refrigerate it. So yeah, man, I'm going to be a big, fat, pork-eating bastard. Oh, shit, I already am. See you later, girls.